stream the qualifying. I'll be stream qualifying. We'll just start it a little bit earlier today. Just when get settled and on track. No, I'm going to rush about 2 minutes qualifying then. So give us a follow if you're on Twitch. Subscribe to the YouTube channel if it makes it that far. Hopefully we'll have a good race. iRacing got a boost last time. Safety rating took a little bit of a knock. 0.4 off a major. Something that's the past. Three races now have all been positive in terms of iRating, I believe. So we'll get. Ooh, dear me. So we'll get set and ready for the race as I nearly dropped my VR headset there. So I'll jump out the car, quickly load up my tune that I've got for this circuit. Qualifying done. So any second this will be ready to go. See what split we've been put into, we'll see if we can work out what split we've been put into and get straight out on track. Probably the last one, I think, at Bathurst for me anyway. I'm not sure what day changes all that. I think it's tomorrow. And I'm not actually sure what the next circuit is, or whether I have it. I'm still missing a few. So we'll see. Ooh, excuse me. Right, here we go then. So, we'll see where we've been placed, see what our car number is, and hopefully it'll either be very low and we'll be in a lower split and we can possibly get on the podium, or it will be very high and we'll be right at the back and see if we can make any gains where people inevitably die around here. Hopefully we'll be looking to get somewhere around the high 201s, low 202s would be good for me. Yeah, but some of these guys in the GT3s are going sub 2 minutes around here, which is crazy fast.
Checker flags out, P7.
Right, so car number 11, so exactly what we didn't want, really, right in the middle. But we'll see where we can qualify, see if we can get a little bit further up the grid than that. But it's pretty accurate. We tend to qualify very near the car number. See if we recognise any names in here. Nope. Make sure everything's feeling okay.
exit's clear. Push.
I noticed earlier spectating one of the quicker guys that he did get into sixth gear here, he just kept revving out. Left it redlining in fifth. So we'll see if that brings us any gains. Car feels good. Stopper really inappropriately on track. And we'll get straight out.
Hit exit's clear. Okay, Duncan, we've got two laps to set a decent time.
Right then, see if we get a banker in the 202s. Be a good start. Thank you. 202 dead. Well, we messed that first turn up, so hopefully we can improve on this. We're down to P7. I think I'm going to improve on this one. A bit sloppy. If we do improve, it's not going to be very much. It's only going to be in the last two turns, down to P9. Other people are going to go quicker, so we might be actually lower on the grid than 11th here. A bit further back than we would like. So a little improvement, I think. Yeah, 2019 took a tenth off, but we're still being pushed back a little. Right, not to worry. This will keep going back. I would have thought we'll keep getting pushed back now as people put the times in. Hopefully we can avoid any first lap drama. Pick up some spots. ...50 seconds in, are we grid up? Give us a follow on Twitch if you're with us. Subscribe to the YouTube channel as well if it makes it that far. So we did what we needed to do there anyway, got into the high 201s, which was the goal. But you can see there, 2:07, so we're a good second off the pace of the front runners here. See if anyone goes sub 2 minutes. Probably in the second or third split, I would imagine, by the pace of the guys in here.
That's the end of the session, P13.
P13 it is. So our setup's loaded. Got the grid. Quickly reset our view and we'll deselect our tyres. Don't need to change them. Crew chief will sort out the fuel for us. I'm not going to worry about that.
So who's going to die on now?
Right. Wonder if that's the orange car that collided with me on the warm up a couple of days ago. Put himself in the wall. Just really unaware of his surroundings on that race. Give him the benefit of the doubt. Not sure if it's the same guy anyway. (Clears throat)
45 minutes. The track temp is 22 Celsius. Follow car number 13 in the left column. Big mess in. Griffin's bend. Yellow flag. Keep your wits about you, mate.
Whoa.
That idiot. Fucking idiot.
Tow truck's going to be busy. Not sure how many GT3s got involved in that. I think it was mainly GTEs
really
in there.
The gap's now 1.1.
Maybe some guys out of position behind me. Yep, so Ferrero is actually car number one.
What? When did I get meatballs? What?
there. Keep your line. Left side's clear. There's a car on your left. Clear left. Car left. Left side's clear. Come on, don't let him get away.
Well and truly picked off there.
P yellow.
Happy for these guys to go through, really. He's been showing much better pace than me. I think I just got lucky in getting past him in the carnage.
There's an incident in. We're cutting. Duncan, stay close. Wait for him to make a mistake.
Then we have a GT3 up there.
No pressure from behind. Hopefully some of these guys will trip each other up. Just about staying with them.
gap to Ferrero ahead is now 1.5 seconds.
Just about within draft. So it looks like he's getting a bit impatient up front. Still quite close to each other up there.
The gap to Ferrero ahead is now 1.5. There's an incident in the chase.
Boys, let's chill for a little bit. Let's chill.
Great, good job. Go. Pass the element. Two freebies there then. See if we can keep them behind. I'm overdriving this a little bit at the moment. Trying to steer with them.
The gap in front is now 1.4. Time was 203.03, sector 2 is 0.7 off the pace. Okay, Duncan, you've got half your fuel left.
It's going to get messy. If these make it down the mountain without wrecking, I'll be very surprised. Separated out a little bit now, so maybe they will. Well, they made it. We're all a little bit closer together, but they made it. Whew, some race. Give us a follow on Twitch if you're with us.
Ne pas garder ta ligne un peu droit.
Two is 0.8 off the pace.
So Sirius behind is closing. Keep an eye on that.
The gap ahead is now 0.6.
So I can't go anywhere when we're bunched like this up and down the mountain, so I may as well ease off, try and fuel save a little bit. A little cautious there, I thought there might have been a bit of contact. Got Grossman's going to the back of Ferrero. 2.1 behind. So he's coming through, I'm just going to let him go because he's got pace. So he'll join this bunch ahead. So it's like the racing equivalent.
All right, Duncan, that's the class car approaching.
Of
the time was at
202.88. A hyena hanging back waiting for someone else to make the kill.
Keep them coming.
And then picking up the scraps. Side by side there.
10 minutes of fuel remaining.
Nothing I can do with that, unfortunately. Might look like I'm a little cautious there, but I can't go in side by side with him, so happy to just sit behind him for now. Cap's only a second behind me now. See if anyone's coming in for fuel. Someone might decide to jump in. There's one.
Thanks, Chappier. The gap behind's increased to 1.2. P8, sector 2 is 1.7 seconds off the pace.
.2 then to series. Side by side, are we up front? Audi's wide. Been making a few mistakes. Mainly up here, he's nearly kissed this wall a couple of times. He's on the brakes again there, so he's obviously struggling.
Track temperature is increasing, it's now 24 Celsius. Okay, Duncan, we're halfway home. Should be about 7 minutes of fuel left. Right side's clear.
I don't know why I've got car contact there, didn't hit anyone.
P6, the car behind's pitting. You've just done a 205.62.
Really not sure where that contact's come from.
I must know.
Car feels okay. This guy behind me made a bit of contact as I was on the brakes, so I was just keeping my eyes forward, so I'm not sure. Do the opposite of this guy. If he comes in, I'm staying out, and if he stays out, I'm coming in. Now he's limping, something wrong with him.
Fuel
I probably just should have eased off there.
20 minutes.
As I got alongside him, I just realised that he might be struggling in the braking zone. Thought he might be coming into me, so I'll give him a bit of room. Too much. Right, Tolzmus for position. Oh, what's that? I must have a bit of damage. Don't seem to have the turn in that I used to. I think I'm going to come in.
Watch your speed limit in the pits. Okay, Duncan, we'll fuel you to the end of the race.
Oh, he's in behind me, he's in better as well. Whoa! Now. Crept up on me. Yeah, he's tucked right in behind me. I'm gonna be battling then.
There's traffic behind, keep your wits about.
Alright, clear right.
I think P6 has gone off in L corner.
On your left. He's still there. Clear left.
Not sure what was going on there with the other guy. Right, I think Bamf touched the wall there. Brakes have gone forward a touch more. All right,
Duncan.
Get a bit of grip.
Left. That's 15 minutes.
Oh no, not damaged.
Rip. Yeah, I got a shit coming down the hill that time.
Probably losing the space much.
Doing what I can to break the toy here, it's not really working. Gap stays the same.
Lap time was at 202.76.
It's a really poor exit. Gonna be right on me then. Just missed a shift going in and then lost the back end coming out.
Okay, Duncan, you're reeling for aero. The gap is now 5.0.
Don't really want to be pushing this hard at this stage in the race, but don't really have a choice.
Don't worry about me, Christoph. I'll wait for him to come out. He's trying to pass you.
Oh shit there. There's been a change of position behind.
The gap behind is now 1.3 seconds.
Excellent.
That lap was at 202.60. Sector 1 is 0.5 off the pace.
Can we get close enough to challenge for aero then? Corner side that we can't. I have a feeling I'm on much better tyres than Ferrero.
Okay, Duncan, 10 minutes to go. That's 10 minutes left.
Out of shape again. So I did increase the gap to Tolsma there, but messed it up. Right, come on. A couple more good laps, I might get in his draft. Thanks, Andrew. Three. Pressure's off behind. So I think just sitting behind them guys while I was scrapping for so long, it's helped me to save my tyres a little bit here, I think. Either that or he's got a bit of damage. Stepped out a little there. Keep in mind that gap behind as well, 3.5, 1.3, so another second we've took out for Aero there. Second a lap.
Alright, Duncan, you're reeling for Aero in. The gap is 1.3. Thank you. 5 minutes remaining, 5 minutes left. Lap time's pretty consistent.
So I'm in no rush here. Hard work's done, just need to sit tight, wait for the opportunity. He's definitely got problems. Really in the wall there. ...3.1 behind. A little bit of pressure mounting now. See, I'm going at this guy's speed, but just took 8 tenths out of me that round bump. See how hard this guy's going to fight. Right then. Great result if we can hold on to this.
That's 5 minutes of fuel left.
Are we getting the white flag? We're not. There's another one after this.
6th place, sector 2 is 0.37 off the pace.
Right. Missed my gear again. Got enough fuel for this. Panicking about how long this fuel warning light's been on now. I think it's good for 3 or 4 laps, but I'm not sure. Crew chief hasn't said anything, so. spanner in the works up front. I'd like this guy to let me past before we start going up the mountain.
To go. That lap time was 202.90. We're running on fumes, mate.
Thanks, Marcel.
Okay, Duncan, there's a faster car approaching.
Ooh, sugar. Making it easy for myself. It's always a relief when you come off the mountain for the last time.
Might be a bit strong. 2 litres remaining. You're pulling away. The gap behind is now 3.3 seconds. Six. That's the end of the race. Never mind.
Never mind. What's the matter with you, Jim? Wow, how good was that race? Whew. Intense. Let's have a look at our incident count. 6, pretty positive as well. And we finished. Let's have a look. So were we 6th in class? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6th in class, 10th overall. Grid 33, so we've made up 23 spots there in the race, so that should be very positive on the iRating. So we'll have a little look at that. But yeah, really good race, we enjoyed that one. So we'll quit out of here, we'll save that replay. So we'll take a look at what it's done to our eye rating and our safety rating. And we just disable high torque mode on the old Simucube, which is amazing, by the way. Massive upgrade. Right, let's have a look. So yeah, people say the pedals are the biggest upgrade in terms of pace, but the consistency is nothing like feeling it with the direct drive wheel. So we've gained, that's not as good as I thought actually, but we've gained 46 I rating and 18 on the safety rating, so positive on both, but I would have liked a little bit more of a bump than that on the I rating. Never mind, 46 positive, 18 positive I rating and safety rating. So we'll tackle that, we'll see what split we're in. I reckon second or third. Yeah, third split. So yeah, if we'd have been in the second split, we'd have got a little bit more. If we finished where we did, but probably wouldn't have finished there. So we've got time 2:02.09. Pretty pleased with that. What was my best lap? Best lap was a 2:02.03. So we weren't really pushing that hard.
terms of body pace anyway. But yeah, happy with that. Cheers for watching on the stream. If you have, give us a follow. And if you're watching via YouTube, click the subscribe button on YouTube, and we'll see you on the next one.